You'll be surprised to know that on YouTube, there are very few videos which tell you how to watch YouTube videos. And that's what we are going to do in this video. Most people watch YouTube either for entertainment or learning. We are, of course, going to focus on learning aspect. We are going to cover all these topics, and you can even download a cheat sheet. The link is in the description. Now, learning also, two types. The most common, I don't know something, I need that answer right now. And the second is, I'm actually learning and I would like to go into details. But before we go into those details, let's look at ads. In fact, nobody wants to look at ads. Most people are trying to find ad blockers, but they don't realize that the best ad blocker is YouTube itself. Go for YouTube Premium. You don't get ads. You pay a small amount to YouTube. In fact, the subscription for family, that is six accounts in India, is just 300 rupees. That's $3. So YouTube Premium is absolute value for money. No. This is not a sponsored video. I have 850 plus videos on this channel. Not a single one is sponsored. I only talk about things which I'm convinced about, I understand, and I feel those will add value to people. Next topic, let's fix the quick fix. I have found the right video, I think, and now I'm going to play it to find the solution. Don't do that. Just pause the video and then think, how do I find the answer quickly? The first thing to look at is this timestamp. And very often you'll see something written there after it. That's a chapter. Now click on that. And now you will see a separate window here with all the chapters. Just look at the chapters and think, whatever you're looking for, where should I go? If you find the right place, go there and click. And now you can play and find the answer. Now let's say you don't find the answer this way, or the particular video doesn't have chapters. Now what to do? Again, stop, don't play. Scroll down. You go to more, you will see lots of things. Finally, you will see transcript. Click on show transcript. Generally, all videos will have a transcript. Even if the creator has not put it, YouTube automatically transcribes. The important thing here is the search text box. So let's say I'm trying to create a quiz. So let's say I have created a quiz and now I want to create a QR code. I just want to know that. So type here QR code, and it found one paragraph where QR code is mentioned. So now what happens? I just click on it. It'll take you to that place. Space bar is to play.
The third option is want to show it during
a... If I use a search word which has many instances, even then it is much better than playing the whole video and trying to find the answer. Now let's look at detailed learning. If it's a long video and you want to make sure what you want is there, another newer option is summarize using AI. You click on share, copy the link, go to Gemini. This is the free version. There are extensions. Extensions are enabled by using @. You obviously want YouTube extension, and then ask YouTube to summarize this particular video. And there you have it, a small summary. And maybe you can find the answer there. This AI summary feature keeps fluctuating and evolving, so check the latest before you try this. For detailed learning, you will have to go through the whole video. These videos can be long. The next thing to decide is the speed at which you will watch the video. Click on this sprocket or gear, go to playback speed, and try different speeds. Now for every video, you may have to adjust it because every person's speed is different. Adjust it to the fastest speed which is convenient to you. There are shortcuts for this. Shift and dot will increase it. 1.25, 1.5, 1.75. Shift and comma will reduce it. Easy. If you just want to go through the video quickly to understand overview, there is a very good shortcut. Look at this. We are at the beginning. This is the end. Right? So if you type 1, look at where this cursor goes. It goes 10%. If I type the number 2, 20%. 5 is 50%. 9 is 90%. 0 is beginning. Even for detailed viewing, the chapters are of course useful because some chapters may be relevant. You can directly skip them. And of course, there are keyboard shortcuts as well. So I am at zero now, beginning. Now, if I want to move to the next topic, which is Copilot quiz prompt or referring to files, I have to press Control or Command, right arrow. That will skip, skip. So very quickly, I skipped two chapters. And now I can press spacebar to play from there. Many videos have promos in them. Now, once you know a promo has started, try a control right, because most creators will have that promo itself as a chapter. So if that is the case, you can quickly skip the promo. Another requirement is you want to look at something in detail. Look at this effect in the beginning. I'll show it again. That's a transition. I want to see how that transition worked. And that happened in less than a second. I want to see it step by step, frame by frame, dot, period, just that, no shift. You see, this is one frame, next frame, next frame. That's how the transition evolved. So if you want to go into minute details frame by frame, dot is next frame, comma is previous frame. Here is another very useful feature. I'm taking the mouse cursor to this red bar or the play bar. Don't click yet. Look at what it's showing you. Pull up for precise seeking. So now drag upwards. Now you'll see a film strip kind of thing. And here now your cursor has changed. Now you can drag it like this. And oh, this is the one I wanted. This particular frame. And double click there to play. Or while you are seeking, go to the desired place and click on the play button or simply press spacebar. It will start playing from that point. Another way of finding precise location. At any point, of course, you can press M is for mute and up arrow or down arrow is for reducing or increasing volume. Of course, you don't have to remember all these shortcuts. Press shift and question mark. That's the only shortcut you need to remember, because all other shortcuts are shown here. Now let's talk about these captions. If you enable this, you will see the spoken audio converted to text. These captions are also customizable, by the way. If you press O, you see the transparency of the text is changing. If you press W repeatedly, the transparency of the background is changing. This is very useful because sometimes text is overlapping on the visual and you can't read the text properly. Also remember plus and minus key. It can increase or decrease the size of the captions. Bottom line is you customize the environment in such a way that your learning is maximized. All this is great, but we are learning. So whatever you learn, you need to capture it somewhere. Keep it for future use. Or in case you forget, you should be able to go to the correct place, correct video, correct point in the video without wasting time. You can go through the history and figure out. And inside history, you can search. Simple. Other option is, if I like a particular video, bookmark it or save it for future use. Under three dots, you will see save. Now, when you say save, it'll ask you which playlist. Watch later is the default, but you can create your own. Also remember, these playlists can be public or private. Lock icon means private. Let's say you're going on a long flight and you want to watch a video. There is a download button, but this is a part of YouTube Premium feature. So download the videos you want to watch before the flight takes off so that you can utilize that time more effectively. Now let's say I found something very useful here and I want to remember that exact spot. Just putting it as save for later is not useful because now the video will start from beginning. I want to remember this point. How do I do that? Click on the share button. Don't copy the link yet. Say start at and now copy the link. Now paste it in your note taking software. I would recommend OneNote, but whatever you like. So now next time you click on that link, it's going to start playing from here. Then there is another clip option. You say clip. Now what happens? It starts playing from where it is. but you can change where it starts and where it ends, and you can have a clip of maximum duration of 60 seconds. Adjust it, give it a name and share clip, and now it'll give you a link. Copy that link and put it in your note-taking software. Another very useful thing is just want a screenshot which solves your problem. There are thousands of applications for screenshot, but Edge browser has its own. So if I want this screenshot, just right click in Edge browser, not on the player, in an empty area, and you will see screenshot. Now you can capture exactly what you want. And while the capture is going on, you can even annotate it so that you can remember something. Once it is done, you copy it and paste it in your note-taking software. Now let's talk about mobile app. Most of the controls are similar, it's just that they are placed differently. Now in the YouTube mobile app, there is no dedicated mute button or volume control. That happens using the volume control of the mobile itself. To pause, just touch it. But generally, you would like to watch videos in full screen. And how do you do that? Just swipe upwards. Now it goes into landscape mode. Let's pause it and see what else happens. Now, when you pause something, it's dim, grayed out, and you want to look at what is happening behind, can't see. Don't worry. You can zoom in, and while it is zoomed in, you can drag it to pan it around. It's a very good way of looking at details which are usually not visible on mobile screen. If you have YouTube Premium, and if you go to the gear icon, then go to additional settings, you'll also get some premium controls, where on this side of the screen, you will get a lot of controls which are otherwise hidden behind somewhere. Now to come back to regular view, swipe down again. Now remember we talked about precise seek, that is also available. This is the play bar, go there and drag it upwards. Now you can scroll horizontally, find the desired place, and then click on the play button. This is another way of finding what you want very quickly. So here is a summary of what we learned. So try this out and let me know your feedback. You have any more questions or I missed something, please put it in comments. Share it with as many people as you can, because everyone watches video and everyone deserves to be more efficient. Remember, like and share and all that is not just something which you are doing, it's between you and me. If you interact with the video in a positive way, YouTube is going to show it to more people, and that way you are also contributing to making people more efficient. So that's it for now. See you next time. Thank you.